Airtable continues to evolve even in late 2024, and today we are very excited to be taking a first look at the new portals feature that Airtable is putting out. Now, this is currently in public beta. You have to apply to be invited, but pretty soon it will be rolled out to all accounts. So if learning more about this new portals feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools. In fact, the tool that helped us start this channel and put us on the map. In today's video, we're going to be taking a deep dive look at the brand new feature Airtable Portals, and I'm very excited. We've known this has been coming for many, many months, but it's only now available for us to start talking about publicly, so here we are. Now, before we jump into things, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. We've put together our Airtable Crash Course to teach you all the key features of Airtable. So if you're a newer Airtable user and you're looking to explore all that Airtable has to offer, grab that free crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and take a look at the new portals. And as you can see right here in the header, we have the ability to now unlock guest access. So really, what is portals? Well, it allows us to bring in a different type of user into our Airtable databases, into our interfaces, and we can bring this person in, multiple people even, and not pay the full price of a standard license. So let's break down exactly what that looks like. So first and foremost, you see here that they're gonna have the interface experience. Now, if you're newer to Airtable or if you haven't started using Airtable interfaces, interfaces are a way that you can share access to the underlying data that you have in Airtable, but you're building a customized user experience. So for example, you might want people to see only specific things inside of your database. You might want them to only edit certain things inside of that database. That is possible using interfaces. You build an interface with only access to the data you want people to see and only access to edit what they can edit, and you give them full control or not, depending on your needs in the interface. Now, interfaces have been around for quite a while, so having an Airtable interface isn't necessarily new news at this point. The difference with portals is that people have a login here, and they're not going to log into Airtable per se. They're going to log into your partner portal. As you see here, here's this example. They're logging into the partner portal. They see that it's powered by Airtable, and when they log in, they're getting access to that interface. So that's one key change. They're not going to Airtable.com and actively logging in, and you're not paying for them as an active user inside of your Airtable account. So in order to get access to portals right now, you have to go through the process requesting early access, but let's see what it has to offer. So first and foremost, the custom sign-in page for guests that we already talked about. So you're giving users, as they say here, outside of your organization. That's a key point. We're going to come back to it. But you're giving these outside users a sign-in page to access the Airtable app for fast and simple collaboration. Remember that they are outside of the organization. These are not folks who are internal to your organization. Now, you also get the same types of things that you were getting in a standard interface, specifically granular permissions and access controls. So you can manage the user access effortlessly, granting and revoking permissions as needed to keep your data secured. So for example, as you can see in the image here, they're saying, hey, this particular partner who's logged into this interface, they can only see data where the partner is the logged in user. So therefore, you could have a lot of data in your database, but people are only going to see the stuff that's relevant to them, where they are the actual active user. This is very similar to how interfaces work already. Now, coming soon, we're going to have the white labeled experience. And so here the portal kind of, you get to take ownership of it. So you can match the app design to your brand and all of this. So here we go. When someone's logging in, they get a very customized login screen with a specific logo, a specific background. So this allows you to take your company branding, your company logo, and just the overall feel of your app. You can take it that much further and really take ownership of it and make it less about Airtable and more about your brand, because you're sharing access with external users to access your app. Okay, let's look at the key features. Explore powerful portal use cases. So we've got creating a portal that fits your team's needs from client management to customer success. Here are a series of different highlighted ideas that Airtable is sharing. So things like client portals, right? Giving your clients, remember external users, giving your clients real-time access to projects, vendor management, so streamlined communication and document sharing with suppliers. Awesome. Partner collaboration, facilitating seamless data exchange with business partners, and customer support. Again, giving people access to the data that matters to them in that particular moment inside of your Airtable base, inside of your Airtable solution, but you have this customized control. So the difference with portals, and this is the key takeaway, this is what so many of us have been asking for so long, is a different price point for people who have a different level of access to Airtable. So here's my key complaint about Airtable is if I'm a builder and I'm going inside of Airtable and I'm building all these amazing automations and databases and all of this stuff, I'm really using the software to the next level. Well, my price per user is the same as the person who accesses my interface and just comes in and looks at a couple things and checks a few boxes. And so it feels really disjointed, really disconnected that these two users who have entirely different experiences have the same price point. Well, portals is the beginning of a solution to take us out of that pricing model that is kind of broken. So the portals add-on is available on the team plan and above. So that would be team, business, and enterprise plus. And for the portals add-on, you can add 15 guests, one portal. So this means for $120, you're getting to add people to your portal at the cost of $8 per guest per month, which is dramatically less than what you're going to be paying if you add users to your Airtable account. Because if you're paying on a monthly plan, as of this recording, the team's plan in Airtable is $24 per month per user. So the portals add-on, if you're utilizing it to its fullest potential, meaning you have 15 guests at $120 per month, then each guest is one-third the cost of what it would be to add a new user. Now, bear in mind that these new guests must be external, right? We've already talked about this a little bit, but if you go down to the FAQ, we can drill into the what or who counts as a guest user. And here we can see that a guest user is considered a user who does not share your team or company's email domain or uses a personal domain. So this basically means that you must be doing business with somebody external to your organization, and they must have a valid business email that is not a free email, and it's not your domain within your organization. That then counts as a potential guest user. Bear in mind, when you give them guest access to the portal, they will only have the ability to log into that portal. What exactly is a portal? It's a tool that allows you to create and customize user experience for an external user. With portals, guest users can sign into your Airtable app through a specialized login page, all the things we already talked about. You're building that interface, giving people the ability to access your data in a very specific way, allowing them to edit only what you want them to edit, but not making you pay full price for that new user. You are going to pay one-third the price, roughly, or even less if you're on a bigger plan. If you're on the enterprise plan, if you're on the business plan, this deal having $120 for 15 guests, therefore $8 per guest per month, is going to result in even more savings for you per new user. Because $24 per month is the cost for a user on the team's plan, and it goes up from there. So having portals access, being able to bring in guests and sharing access to your data is so much simpler now to bring more people in. Bear in mind, they have to be external to the organization. Now, lastly, I want to drill into how does pricing work. The portals add-on is available for team plan customers starting at $120 per month for 15 guests. For business and enterprise customers, custom pricing is available. Bulk discounts are available for a large volume of guests. So we need to, of course, reach out to Airtable. This is a brand new feature. It's still in early beta. So there's going to be some kinks to work out. We should expect that. But this is kind of the starting point, right? Now, we'll see if this ends up being the final pricing. I don't really know. I couldn't speak to that in terms of what's to come, but it's a great first start. This allows us, again, to give new external users access to the vital information without paying full price for that user, because let's face it, they don't have the same functionality that a standard user in Airtable would. Now, also note that billable seats for guest users will be counted when a guest user is invited to your portal app with editor or commenter permissions on the team plan. And additionally, guest users will be charged as a full collaborator seat if they are added to multiple apps or if they are invited to the underlying base for the app. So, key takeaways here. If you're inviting guests, do not invite them to multiple apps and do not invite them to the underlying base inside the app. Only invite them to the one interface, only one that you are granting access for that portal experience. Remember, if they're going to multiple interfaces, if they have access to the underlying data, you're going to be billed as a standard user for that particular account. They are not going to be a guest in your portal guest count. So there you have it. I will be sharing this link for access to Airtable's portals. If you want to apply and get early access, feel free to follow that link, get that going for you. This new feature will help you take your Airtable interfaces to the next level. Again, sharing externally with people outside of your organization and in a way that is going to cost you a third or less of the cost of a standard seat on your plan. This is a pretty exciting feature. Let me know in the comments below what you think about it and if you are as pumped as I am that we are starting to get some flexibility in this Airtable pricing plan. Any questions you have that I didn't quite address in this video, feel free to swing by our website and reach out. And of course, most importantly, keep on building.